Did you know you can support the Techology Show when you shop at Amazon.com? Become a friend of the show by starting your shopping at thetechologyshow.com/shop. It's Tuesday, November 19th, 2013, live from Roll Pickin', South Carolina, Techology Show Podcasting Hall.
A.K.A. Tony's bedroom.
Matthew T.G.
Lost my train of thought. I'm Heath Mulligan.
And I'm Tony Casey. Welcome to The Techology Show, a weekly podcast featuring technology, theology, and everything in between. This is episode 226, and I am coming to you with a voice that's about 75%.
Hey, you should have heard him this past Friday or Saturday.
Oh, yeah. Tony called me the other night. I'm just like...
It sounded, come over there? It sounded like a horror movie. Hello, this is Tony.
Come down, come Tony.
It was rough.
Hey, listen, last week we just made you aware of some relief efforts going on in the Philippines concerning the hurricane there, Typhoon Haiyan. And so just want to, again, just highlight that. Please take some time out. You may not be able to give much, but if you just go to the link that we have in the show notes, we have a couple opportunities, one through our own denomination, another through the Red Cross, and we encourage you to
hey,
do that.
Hey, if you're watching live, just click that right up there, that banner.
No, down. Push down. Go.
Oh, no, up. Oh. Right up above us, there is a banner. I'm telling you, if you're watching the live page
I'll
right
take
now,
it by faith. I'll
right
take
up
it by
there,
faith.
There's a banner. Go click it.
All right.
I'm not watching live. And also, we want to say thanks again to Dr. Joanne Lyon for joining us. That was just awesome of her to do that. And you heard at the top of the show, you know, you can support this show. There's an Amazon link on our page. You can also go to thetechologyshow.com/shop and just help us out, you know, just by doing your normal shopping on Amazon. And this week's purchase of the week.
Come on.
And we're going to be putting out feelers to see who bought this. The Mel Brooks Blu-ray collection.
The altar is open. And repent.
Blazing saddles.
All right, listen, also, we want to let you know that if you're looking for an effective way to get word out about your organization, business, or nonprofit, why not consider sponsoring an episode of The Technology Show? When you sponsor this show, we'll feature your brand right on the front page of our site, as well as inside the episode that you've sponsored. This means that your investment literally lives on years after the week you sponsor. We think it's a great deal and would love to have you on board. So check that out. For more details, go to thetechologyshow.com/sponsor.
Yeah.
2 weeks ago, we had one of our favorite guests, favorite people, favorite pastors on, Mark Batterson.
Brother Batterson.
Author of the new book, All In. And we're giving away not one, but two copies. One, a real version. One, a Kindle or ebook version, however how you want it. So, our first winner, who will get a choice of physical or ebook version, a new listener, and a new winner, first time winner, Joel Higginbotham. Thank you for entering. You have won. We'll be sending you a message and figuring out what you want. And our second winner, good friend of the show, and related to our last winner, Doug Dennis. Doug, you've won a copy of All In. And again, we'll be...
You get Joel's leftovers.
You get whatever Joel doesn't want, we're going to send to you. So, hey, thank you guys so much for entering. Zondervan actually retweeted our contest link. So that was the highlight of my week.
Yeah. Okay, so today is a different show. We're not interviewing anybody. We call this our Black Friday special, where we talk about gadgets. And I made a promise last week to you, our listeners and viewers, and that is this, that I would have a special treat for all of you. And so, Heath, this does involve you, because a few months ago, we got into a conversation about the movie A Christmas Story.
Yes.
And as we talked about that, we talked about the pajamas that he wears. And I just made the comment that, you know, you said you'd wear them. And I said, if I had a pair, you'd wear it. Oh, yeah. I said, no, you wouldn't. So, Heath, we're gonna make you go ahead and
This is a surprise. This was the surprise you mentioned.
So Matthew and I went in together. I want you to know that we went havers. Come on, put it on. No, you got it.
Go ahead.
Get it on. Yeah, put it on.
I don't have to leave the room to put it
on. Oh,
in.
No. You put it on right here. Okay. Matter of fact, get in the camera shot to get over a little bit because I emailed a few of our viewers and listeners yesterday and told them that you know they would be able to see you putting. So, yeah, we got. He probably can't wear the mittens, but there's a hat in there. Oh, look at here. We have the shoes as well. Oh, this is nice. Here we go. Just getting into the spirit here. Listen, let me tell you what I did, Heath. The day that we talked about that on the show, I put a reminder.
I've never even seen a Christmas story. That's what I get for answering a bet I didn't know.
Yeah, so I put this on the calendar. The day that you said it, I put it on the calendar. As a reminder for October the 1st to order this outfit. There we go. Nice, nice.
This is really the
this is thing. It. This is the creme de la creme. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go ahead. Get it on. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Looking good, man. Looking good. Oh, this is... And guess what else came with it? There we go. There we go.
Here's your gloves.
All right.
All right, sir. You don't have to wear those. I know that, too.
You're in the chat room. How was this not the purchase of the week on Amazon?
That is beautiful. That is just beautiful. All right. So let's talk about...
Hold on. All right.
Now we did. You know, it's a little cold in the studio. In
here. That's what you said.
We told you.
It's about to get warm.
We told you. Don't worry. It's gonna warm up. And so,
I don't know that everybody got. Let's if you can do the other shot. Let's see.
Oh, we can't.
Got a shot of the shoes.
Oh, you'd have to actually move your leg into the camera.
Oh, that hurt. Okay. I hate y'all.
All right. So, it's going to be hard to recover here.
Oh.
All right. So, this is our Black Friday special. We're going to talk about just gadgets that we like and that we recommend for the holidays. As we start off here, Matthew, you've got some wisdom here from Lifehacker.
All right. So, Lifehacker published a story from, let's see, where is it? NerdWallet. I've never heard of NerdWallet, but I do follow Lifehacker. And we're going to link you to it in the show, but it's a tip on how to get all the Black Friday deals without all the hassle and rush
of Black Friday.
I'd never even thought of, but when I heard about this story, it's like a light bulb went off in my head. It's like, absolutely, why have I never thought of this before? So many of your credit card companies, particularly Discover Card and MasterCard, offer price matching or price protection. And what they're saying is that if you, like this week, if you go out and you can get in advance some of the Black Friday deals, there's even apps for your phone and stuff like that, those things have leaked. You go out and buy what you want to buy on Black Friday, buy it tomorrow, and then go to the store and get the hard copy of the ad or buy the newspaper and get the hard copy of the ad.
Yep.
All you've got to do then is contact the credit card company and say it was on sale for a better price, and they will deduct that difference price. And now without having to fight the hassle of going out on Black Friday or getting up early or whatever it is, you've done all that shopping. I think it's a fantastic idea. As long as you're faithful to follow through, with the turning in of the stuff. But yeah.
Yeah, and you have linked our listeners and viewers to the story that was on Lifehacker as well.
So all definitely check that out.
So we're going to jump into, we'll each just take a turn here. So I'm going to start us off. And, there's lots of tablets out there. I think the Nexus 7 tablet's a great tablet. Good reason to buy that. Obviously, iPads, different sizes, things of that nature. But if you're, my dollars are restricted, you're looking for just a basement, bottom basement tablet, for a decent price, One of the things I recommend is the Kindle Fire HD. Now, this is not the newest version. I'll talk about that later. But the Kindle Fire HD, I have one of these.
Yes.
The cost is $139. It's a full-blown tablet.
Yes.
And then you get all of the features that come only through their tablet. One, and the biggest one is that the text-to-speech. So it will read any book to you, even if it's not a, doesn't have the professional narration to it. It's a little bit restrictive. It runs Android, and so it's not like the Nexus 7, which has the full-blown market. But again, my thing is this. If you're just looking for what's the cheapest tablet I can get, and yet it be a quality tablet,
yes,
this is one that I would highly recommend.
There you go. Okay. So carry us on there, Tony. I didn't know how we're doing this. Are you just
going to do your five, or we just going to take turns?
Walk us through your
my
five.
My whole then. List?
Yeah,
okay. So now, let me go to, so my second one is, again, in the whole tablet space, I think that if you're looking for one of the latest ones out there, I think Kindle Fire HDX. But this one, again, I'm very specific. If you're a person, you're not high tech, you need someone to walk you through things, I recommend this because it has a feature called the Mayday button. When you hit the Mayday button, with Amazon's commitment is that within 10 minutes, you'll have live tech support come on your tablet screen. They can't see you, but you can see them. They will circle areas on your screen where you need to push, select, and even if you have to enter a private code, they shut off the camera feed. They cannot see that, and then you alert them as to when you're done with that. And so, again, for a person, if you're not tech savvy and you just need someone to walk you through things, I recommend the Kindle Fire HD.
So can they see what's on your screen?
Yes.
Yes. But they can't see you. They don't activate your camera, but you can see them. You can see the tech support that's coming to you.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, I can definitely, like, I can think of some people.
I can too.
Mothers and fathers.
Yeah.
And
yeah, and so I want to be.
This would be super handy for.
Yeah, and so I want to be clear on both these tablets I've recommended. I'm not saying that necessarily the best on the market. What I'm saying is, given certain things. So if you're looking for a basement, a tablet, Kindle Fire HD. Yeah. If you're a person who needs tech support, needs someone to show you what to do, then I recommend this tablet.
Elizabeth says in the chat room that with their Kindle Fires, Amazon does a free app every day. And it may not be the best app, but they do a free app every day.
Yeah.
And I think we all would agree on this. I know you've spoken to this issue before, is a lot of people are going out and getting these $100 Android tablets.
Oh, my word.
And they're a disaster.
Spend the extra $50.
That's right. The Kindle Fire receives our, as far as the price range, it receives our highest
rating. Most bang
rating
for the buck, probably. And don't ever buy your tablet from CVS. Don't ever buy it from the local drugstore.
What about a truck stop? I saw a truck stop.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah. So the HDX is very tempting. I mean, I remember talking to you about it. It's a pretty big toss-up between that and the new Nexus 7. They're very similar hardware-wise, but the thing that just differentiates this is that Mayday. And I can, I mean, I can tell you, I'm not going to name names, but I can tell you some people who would benefit greatly from that.
Well, see, now, totally lost my train of thought.
Okay. So the third thing on my list, I had this on last year, and I just bring it up again.
Making a comeback.
$40 bucks for this device, the OBI or OB100. What you do is there's a picture of it. Matthew put it up.
The Obi-Wan Kenobi.
You get a Google Voice telephone number, totally free. You pair that number up with this device. It runs through the internet. This is our home phone. It has worked flawlessly, and I like it because it integrates with Google Chrome, the Google Voice thing. I can actually be out of town and see when the phone is ringing here. If no one's here,
I'll pick up on it. Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And sometimes I do it just to mess with my wife. Like, she knows I'm out of town. I see she's calling the house, and so I'll answer the, hello? Yeah. I'm knowing that she's not.
She still hasn't figured that out.
No, one day she said, well, she gets it now, but the first time it is, she goes, Tony?
I thought you were in Chicago.
I have no phone bill, so it's a one-time fee.
That's awesome.
$40. It's a little less than 40, matter of fact, $40. And here's what we did. We also linked you with a demonstration of how to set that up in your home so that once you get your Google Voice number.
Yeah. Now, all this is contingent on Google and the Google Voice platform. And so far, they've been keeping it free. But every year, there's kind of this question. Okay. You know, they usually make an announcement at the beginning of the year. Hey, just so you know, United States calling, Canada calling. It's totally free. Yeah. If you have family that lived in Canada, this is a great thing to do. Yeah. My sister-in-law is set up. We created her a Google Voice number to where it's a North Carolina number to where her family can call her using a local number and it rings in her apartment in Canada.
Wow.
Isn't that cool? So. Now, I mean, I think the value of this to somebody on the mission field, like if you can get some sort of internet, I've been saying this a little bit, but I've just never got anybody to jump on. But like I think about like the Edmonds while they were there in Haiti. You know, if there was a way to tie this in, you'd have a local South Carolina number that in your Haiti. Family could call that would ring in Haiti.
Right, yeah. All right, so the third thing on my list is this little device right here. Mm. This is the JLab Crasher Bluetooth speaker. When it first came out, they were $200. Over the course of the 2 years, it has continued to come down in price. So the picture of the one Matthew just put up on the screen, they vary in price due to color. So that's the most expensive at $75. They go all the way down to $70 brand new, depending on the color that you pick. In their demonstration video, they show a car running over this. It is something that's durable. If you drop it, it's not just going to shatter on you or bust. And the portability of it's what I like. So when I'm traveling, I'll set it up. I set up in the back of the car, use it as a main speaker. In our living room, I used to have speakers that I would plug in my tablet or smartphones. We always play dinner music when we're eating. Now I just have this. I can take it anywhere. Again, the highest price on it is $75. The cheapest is $70. Highly recommend it.
Yeah. And that one, I'm going to take home for free.
No, you got your gift. You're wearing your gift. You look good too, by the way. You're gonna say
I'm gonna
now,
be wearing now this when my say kids this. Get
you
home
have
today.
A Bluetooth speaker that I think is outstanding as well.
Yeah, so and there the price just continues to drop on it too. It's made by Logitech. It's a Logitech UE, which stands for Ultimate Ears, and just this little tiny thing. They're fantastic. They really are nifty. And what's cool about it, I don't know about this guy, but I know that with the one that I have, you can pair 8 devices to it at the same time. You don't have to. Okay,
pair that's 5, good. I believe that's
which just means that like you can without having to go through a lot of hassle, I can switch from playing something off a phone to playing here, and it all just works great. And
yeah, also really too, these fantastic. Have a built-in mic, so if I'm using this as my speaker for my iPhone, the phone rings, I can choose on the iPhone which device do I want to use as my mic. And my listening device, if I choose this, then it can just pick up my voice and I can talk through this device, and highly recommend it.
So they have a built-in battery. I don't know if we talked about this yet either, but doesn't have to have a wire plugged up to it. Right. So you charge it and you just carry it wherever. Super cool. I took it to Haiti. Again, this is and me and the guys who were working on hanging ceilings, we blasted all kinds of, well, I didn't. A guy on our team blasted all kinds of country music all day long
and
over that thing.
When I ran this for 11 hours straight coming back from Chicago, and
nice.
And it never ran out of power, which I was shocked by. I thought, well, at some point here it'll run out. Listened to almost 2 full books, and it never ran out of power. Mm. All right, the last thing on my list is I think that the Roku is just this great device. If you're not familiar with Roku, again, you hook it up to the internet. These are wireless, or you can use a landline to plug into it. And it just brings all of this streamed content that you have over the internet, and it aggregates it and brings it into an interface, plugs into your TV. I pick the Roku, too, because it does 1080. Yeah. And this is a $79. You can actually get the cheaper one, which is $40. It's not 1080p. But it's like a entry level device. I know a friend of mine, Bill Cody, who has gotten 2 of these now and put them on both his TVs. He loves it. And again, it just aggregates internet content. And so you can play these shows, and it just hooks up as an auxiliary to your TV. So that completes my Black Friday list for 2013.
Very good, Tony. Some good choices there.
Yeah.
All right, Heath.
Sorry, I'm allergic to pink. So the first thing I want to put on here is the Seize the Year 2014 calendar. It's $24.99 for the dry erase model. There's also a 1999 paper model. And what this is, it's literally a calendar that'll fill up your door, but it has no gaps. We got the one where, I don't know about you, I'm a pastor, and so Sunday is a big part of our week, but it's always confusing because Saturday's on one side of the calendar and Sunday's on the other side of the calendar. So we got the one, the calendar actually starts on Monday, and we have actually gone through and planned out our entire 2014 year. I mean, there's no gaps in it. You can really see how all your weeks flow together. It was a wonderful, wonderful.
Are you using the dry erase one?
We got the dry erase one, and we've got it on our laundry door. And so, like, you go in and you kind of hit the laundry door of your hip because you're carrying laundry. And so that part is getting erased a lot. So we're going to have to go.
So that week's always open for you.
Yeah, that week.
Hip week is always open.
Well, that's Christmas 2014, so there's nothing that week. But just so you guys know, every Tuesday, matter of fact, Drake said last night, he says, why does it say tech every Tuesday? I said, son.
There we go. Educational moment. That's right. A precious moment right there.
So, again, if you are a parent, even if you're not a parent, highly, highly recommend it. It was
so you
awesome.
Use that as a family calendar.
Yes. We okay. put...
Now, that's a good idea. Now, that really is.
We put it on there. I put all of our district board of administration meetings, so my wife knows what Saturdays I'm going to be on. We do finger foods at church one
Saturday. See, I was not interested in this at all till you said it's a family calendar.
I mean, you can look at the calendar and you can see, like, we've already planned. We know when spring break is. We've already planned our vacations.
That's smart.
We know what conferences. I mean, it is just the view of it is really, really good. And if you don't like the portrait view, it does have a landscape view on.
And how big is this thing? I'm looking at the picture here.
Oh, it's huge. I mean, it's taller than I am.
Like if I pasted it to
with the ears or without?
pre-ears.
I just got to say, you look so good. I'm a little distracted.
This is going to be a tradition. it's a great calendar. So.
I wish there was a way to like high five across the. Yeah, yeah. That was like, yeah.
So the second thing that I want to put on there, and this is what we got last year. So this is the model that's a year old. It's about $110. You can probably find it cheaper a couple places. Is the Keurig K-Cup Brewer.
Good choice.
Oh, my goodness. Life-changing. I mean, I have had more coffee and green tea and cocoa this year than ever before. You just keep the thing. I can wake up in the morning. If the thing's full, turn the power on. In about 30 seconds, it's ready to go. Brew my coffee. Boom, 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 boom. Super easy. Amazon has great deals also on variety of coffees. If you are a coffee drinker or you know a coffee drinker, I highly suggest this.
So it's all good except when you're a major coffee drinker. Like when you drink a lot of coffee, you can really wipe through some stuff on this thing.
Okay,
but here's where I think that it would be hugely useful for a guy like me.
Okay.
Okay. In the office at the church.
Yes. And see, the other thing is, let's say you might be watching this and saying, hey, it's going to get expensive with the K-Cups. Okay. So you can buy the little adapter and you can buy Folgers or whatever kind of coffee you want. Right.
And fill
it yourself. You can. I know, Tony, you drink a lot of tea.
Right.
And so you can just do water. You don't have to put a cup in there. You can put bag tea and do
so
it
I'm
like
excited
that.
So I'm excited because I, too, have some coffee choices for everybody a little later on. And
Can I say something else? We are not coffee drinkers, and this is exactly why I've been lobbying my wife to get one, because here's what happened. Our coffee grounds set up till we wait for some guest, and so we're giving them trashy coffee.
And let me attest, as somebody who has had said coffee.
and my thing is this, if you're not a coffee drinker, get this for your guest so that when they come, they get a fresh cup of coffee.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. I see that Priscilla is in the chat room saying there's an app for the calendar. And there is, I mean, I mean, I got it, really. I mean, just being 100% honest, I know it's hard to take me serious. I'm wearing a rabbit suit. But, you know, my family is going through some life changes, and I, you know, it's not enough for me to have all this on my
phone.
I mean,
something I've
gotta
physical
have,
there in front
I've
of gotta the
have
family
something
is a
physical
big deal.
This is what I like
to see.
I didn't even, I dismissed this until the whole idea, how you were using it. And so I went back and looked. I looked at the size and everything. I would love to get this so that my wife puts her stuff. Nicole puts her stuff.
Yeah.
We have a daughter in high school. And so sometimes those things don't get coordinated. Yeah. If you have this physical calendar where everyone's writing and you see it and it's a centrally located place, I think it's a smart idea.
And get everybody their own colored, their own colored dry erase marker. And you can purchase this calendar via the affiliate link
That's right.
in our show notes.
I noticed that.
And I know we need to move on, but, you know, for us, you know, I've been in ministry 15 years now, and I can't tell you how many unused vacation weeks that I have, because summer gets here, and you're like, oh, you know, what are we doing? We have to say that. And, we literally sat down and marked, we've already marked.
And everyone sees it. Yeah.
And everybody knows what we're doing. So, all right. So
look at this next one.
The next one. Now this is great. $129.99. The X-Men, the Adamantium collection. It includes
Wait X-Men. A minute. So you can either get a tablet or the X-Men.
Tony. It's Adamantium claws.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Obviously I'm ignorant.
You get X-Men 1, X-Men 2, X-Men 3, the two Wolverine movies so far. You get X-Men First Class, and you also get a bonus disc, bonus features, X-Men.
And it comes with the claws? Wolverine.
It comes with the claws. That's why, yes. Mm.
See, obviously I spoke from my ignorance, so I apologize.
Yes, it comes with the claws. And I let me check. I want to make sure.
So
I believe these are wearable.
Okay, and let's say that there's another X-Men movie, you know, just right around the corner. Let's say that there's Days of Future Past.
Yes, this would get you ready for that.
Okay.
All right. This
would get you ready for that.
So obviously I'm not into the X-Men franchise.
Well, that's why no one likes you. Okay, so that's for the geek in all of us. And there's also, you know, if you got a geek in your house, there's a great Dark Knight collection, Man of Steel, especially. So now... So the calendar, it was taking something we normally do digitally, making it paper. So this next thing does the opposite. It's the Neat Receipts mobile scanner, and the one I've got is for the Mac. It's $179.
You have this?
No. It's the one I have here. Oh, it's the one I want, hint, hint.
great. If anyone's listening.
It's a great pastor's gift for Christmas. Here's what it does, and they have one for PC too. This is what's great. Now you can use a regular scanner. You can scan it into your computer. You can scan your bills, all that stuff, your receipts. You can scan it into Evernote or whatever file you're using. But here's the thing with the Neat Receipts: you get a receipt. Say you're taking somebody out to eat for church that you're going to get reimbursed for. You scan this receipt. It creates an Excel file with all of the information that you can go in, type it in, and guess what? I don't know about you. I'm a pack rat. We have papers everywhere. This lets you go completely paperless.
I thought you were a pack rabbit, but anyway.
What's up, Doc? So, anyway. So, I mean, I was going through all my receipts for the church the other day. Disaster. This, boom. You scan your bills right in, creates a PDF, scans it into an Excel file.
It's even supposed to categorize them.
Yes.
So, it knows that this gas. I've never seen it put in use, but the way that it's billed, it's really...
I've seen the promos, and my thing is, I would love to know someone who has one to see what they... Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was actually at a business... Oh, it was we were at the hospital, and they had one of these, and so you gave them your... When you gave them your license, they just put it in there. Now, this is the mobile version. This is a small one. They have them up to like $350 where it's got a specific business card slot, credit card slot, lots of different things. And again,
and it's usually a feeder system, isn't it?
It feeds
it through.
Yeah.
It goes through.
Yeah. And this mobile one, again, $179, but it works. It does everything. You can scan business cards. You can scan receipts. Alrighty. You can scan your bills. But... it's time to save some trees and go paperless. So Here's the last thing I want to share. Now, this one's just for fun. You guys know we do a show here. Lots of churches do video announcements, do youth group videos. Well, here's what you're missing, okay? It's the ePhoto 10x20 muslin chroma key, green screen, background support, stand, and kit. Now, here's what you get. It's a $209. You get the green screen with the stands. You get multiple lights. You get a case to carry it all in. And I'm trying to see what else was in there. But we used this at our youth group in Denton and loved it. We actually did our youth announcements. We had a weather girl, and so she would stand in front of the green screen, and we'd put the weather map behind her. And that's what they're doing on NBC. That's all it is. It's just this. So you can be like John Cesarich, Channel 4 weatherman. And if you've got, I know particularly in iMovie, using a green screen, really easy. I mean, it's just something you film with a green screen, click a couple of buttons, and you can throw up your images back there. It's not too complicated. It comes with instructions.
What if I want it just for the dampened lights?
Yeah, I mean, that's worth it. Just, so you might want to buy that for the technology show because we need some new studio.
Just buy a few of them using our affiliate link, and then we'll have the money to buy our own.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. But anyway, even if for your family, kids love the green screen because they don't know what you're going to throw up behind them. So it's the magic of Hollywood in the privacy of your own home.
Nice.
Very bitch. Frightening to think about. All right, so I think we're on to me, and I need you guys' help. I've been putting the links to all of these products in our chat room as we've been going on so people know. So you guys help me out because I'd have to talk and do all this at the same time.
You need to get that. So here we go.
First off for me, and this is something that I found recently. I actually ordered this. I'll be getting it, I think, tomorrow it arrives. $20. It is a 5-port USB charger that plugs into the wall. It charges at different amperages, so it can charge two iPads at the same time at the full charge speed.
Nice.
It's got then just some regular 1 amp and then one 1.5 amp. Well, the cool thing about these USB things, if you've ever wondered, if you have a USB charger for another device, it's all 5 watts. You're not going to ever burn out a device by plugging it into the wrong charger. The higher the amperage, the faster it's getting the electricity to the battery, and so it'll charge your device quicker. So rather than, like, for somebody like myself who on their nightstand is charging 4 to 5 things every night, not having to have a power strip with 4 to 5 little wall warts in it and reducing that down to 1 is fantastic.
I'm
really excited to get a hold of this thing. So that's $20. And you guys have got the link there in the room. Right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Go ahead.
And a lot of people don't understand, that, like, Nicole doesn't get it, that the iPad will charge quicker if you use the big adapter as opposed to the small one. The other one's like a trickle charge.
Yeah.
She just doesn't make that
distinction. Because it's a really big battery in there, and so that 2.1 amps will literally charge it 2 times as fast as a 1 amp charger will.
Yeah, this is a good practical
gift. It's a great thing. I'm excited to get my hands on my own. It'll be coming with me to my family's house for Thanksgiving instead of having to pack 5 different things. Yep. I can take one thing with. Super excited about this.
Yeah, man.
So this next one that I have for you all is something that I bought for my wife recently. She's a huge fan of, there are these like porous pins. Paper Mate used to make them. They were blue. She just loved them. And I found this set right here. This is like, I believe there's 20 or so pins in this collection. It's like the whole rainbow color. They're not like permanent markers, but they're fine tipped in the same way that a fine tip Sharpie is. She thinks they are fantastic. She absolutely loves them, particularly when she has to do a lot of writing in her lab books as she's going through procedures and even being able to color coordinate different steps and stuff, she thinks is really cool. If you like to draw, these things are big time as well. A lot of people that purchase them do them to draw with. But I think the thing that really sets them apart that she really loves is the case that they come in. It's a roll-up case with Velcro around it.
Oh, wow.
And she literally, she has her big purse and she literally just throws that roll of pins they're into her purse, and they all stay together in the right order and don't go anywhere. She thinks it's great. Now, on that note, you know, as I was going through this and putting this together, she also wanted me to talk about fleece-lined tights. Now, I don't have a picture to show you, but her new fascination, now that she's got the pins taken care of, is tights lined with fleece. So it's like...
Much like this costume.
Maybe.
Because it's tight.
I don't know. It's her. That's her deal. So you might see a link for that in the show notes afterwards. Next one that I've got is an exciting one. And I think Tony, you witnessed this thing in use a little bit, but I don't think we've got the full understanding of it. It is the Joby Grip-Tight Gorilla Pod. And it is designed to hold a smartphone or other device like that. And then these legs, I'm going to throw up another picture. So just indulge me here for a moment while I do this.
I think Paul Brown has this. He's a reporter.
Right here you go. So these legs can wrap around and grip anything and hold your phone there. And I used this, again, in Haiti, is what I was using to carry around when we were doing a live Skype call over a cell phone.
Right.
It's what that was attached to. But you can also set up pictures and all kinds of different things this way using little stand. It is really cool. Now, the great thing about this one is that little gripper, let me switch back to the other picture here. The gripper that is holding that phone unscrews, and that is a standard camera mount screw. Hmm. So if you had a little camera that has, like if you have a point and shoot that has the little screw hole in the bottom, you can take off the phone gripper. And it can just be a little tripod for just a regular camera. So it's just really great.
So our friend Paul Brown, who is a photographer, videographer, I said reporter a while ago. I met photographer, videographer. He has actually, on rare occasions where he's taken pictures at accident scenes, has used this, put his iPhone on it, and taken the picture that way. And it makes it to the Greenville News.
Yeah. Yeah, it's amazing. It's crazy. I mean, it should freak him out how crazy and how easy it is for everybody to do what, you know, 20, 30 years ago was really difficult.
Yeah.
Next one. Heath, I'm going to play off your coffee thing.
All right.
I'm going to take you to Coffee Nirvana.
Okay.
And we were supposed to pick five things. I'm calling Coffee Nirvana one thing, but it's made up of three items that will make Coffee Nirvana you.
Yeah.
The first one is the AeroPress. This looks like something that would come straight out of a science lab. It's wild. I have one. I should have brought it with me today. Mm-hmm. But if you're making, this is kind of like Keurig, if you're making a single cup or anywhere from 1 to 4 cups of coffee, this thing is fantastic. It's amazing. So you put the kettle on the stove, heat up the water, put the grounds in there. It's super easy to clean up. I can't describe without actually like sitting down and showing you the process of doing it, but it makes a great cup of coffee. Really cool little device. $25 to $29, just kind of depending on the day that you're there at Amazon taking a look at it. So that's one. And then the next one is something I don't have yet, but I'm kind of hinting about, and I'm hoping that it comes my way soon. This is an automatic milk frother and warmer. So you know how, like, when you go to Starbucks or wherever, and they got the espresso machine there. And I said espresso, it's espresso, my bad. They have the little milk steamer that froths the milk and steams and does all that. Well, without having one of those in your house, or a less than ideal one, what do? Well, this is just this, it's like a little electric tea kettle. It has a base. You fill it up with milk. In the bottom, it has a little whisk and a heating element, and it heats and frosts the milk. And it doesn't use steam to do it. It just does it all in there. And then you have it, and you use it, and you make your thing. So Ashley and I, in the evening, I've just been using the microwave and a measuring cup. I'll make a decaf coffee for each of us in that AeroPress. And it literally makes a shot of espresso in each one of our coffee cups, the AeroPress does. Mm. And then I have the warmed up milk, and I'm making a latte, essentially, is what I'm making.
Yeah.
It is great. So I'm excited. I'm hoping that something along these lines comes my way for Christmas this year.
That's also a great improvement. We had an espresso machine here, and Dana was the only one that actually figured out how you could steam that milk.
Yeah.
The rest of us made a mess, man.
Yeah.
But she figured it out.
It shoots everywhere.
It's a lot harder than it looks.
Yes, yes. So tip your barista, okay? Because it is a skilled job that they're doing. Let me see if I can get this next picture loaded up here. Come on, picture. And this is the final item for Coffee Nirvana. This is the Contigo Auto Seal mug. It has a button on it. It will keep coffee hot forever, or tea, or whatever. I mean, it is tremendous.
Or tea. And the That's reason, what I wanted to hear.
The reason this thing is so good is for somebody like, again, my dear wife. She, if she has an open container, it will spill. She will spill it. She will find a way to do it. And she told me I could share this on the show. I asked
good. Permission. Yeah, it's good.
It will spill. And so she has one. I got it for Christmas last year. It's pink, not black. So if you're getting one for me, Heath, you could go for pink. It would match his outfit. But for me, definitely go black. And it creates like this airtight seal. You can't spill it without pressing the button. It will not.
That's not that bad of a price either.
No, it's $22. Keeps it hot for hours. A fantastic mug. And one day she lost it. She left it in the library at Clemson. And so she went to school the next day with a regular mug that had a lid in it. And she had gotten so used to this that she just carries it just sideways down the hall, you know, just sideways. And so she's going down the hall with this coffee mug that she's got now. And she just is hearing this trickling sound. And she's like, I wonder what that is. Gets all the way down the hall and turns and looks and sees she has a trail of coffee all the way down the hall that she had to go back and clean up because she'd gotten so accustomed to this mug. But she absolutely loves it. So let me recommend that.
So now let me ask this question, Tej. What if we're kind of wrapping things up? What if, and what about that person who has everything?
Everything. I mean, everything. Well, I have something for them too. And you know who to turn to for the person who has everything.
Yes.
Let me try to find the picture here. Where is
this
it?
This would be at? Good here.
And come on. Well, I tell you, I don't have the picture. So here is the review of it from CNET. I've got a video review. This is called the Orbotics Sphero.
I'm David Carno, executive editor for CNET.com, and I'm going to give you a quick look at the Orbotics Sphero 2.0. This is the successor to the original Sphero, which came out in late 2011, and it looks identical to the original, except it now goes faster, and the LED lights inside it are brighter, three times brighter. This is one of those products you're going to either think is really kind of clever or a little bit stupid. You control it with an app. It's compatible with Android or iOS devices. And there are over 25 apps out there that let you play with this, whether it's by yourself or with others who own Sphero balls. And there's some augmented reality games. What's kind of interesting is the new Sphero does come with a couple of accessories. It has a couple of ramps that are actually built into the packaging on the box. There's also a few optional accessories. There's a nub that goes around the ball. It's kind of a silicone nub, and that allows you to take it on surfaces, whether it's smooth surfaces or even in water. The ball is waterproof. In case you're wondering how this charges, it's through inductive charging. You're gonna get this little stand here. You do plug it into the wall. It takes about 3 hours to charge for 1 hour of drive time. The ball does connect via Bluetooth through your portable device, but it is better range than your typical Bluetooth. It is 30 meters instead of 30 feet. And it does require a bit of a learning curve to really learn how to drive it.
So, Stevin Sheets, one of our viewers, listener, Stevin Sheets, man, I mean, he needs
this. This is a gift for him. Now, it doesn't sound too cool. Until
what?
All right, so it's like, okay, it's a ball that you roll around in your phone until you start to think of some fun things that you could do. So check this out.
That's great.
Yes. So this is what I'd be doing with it if I had it. And anybody who knows me well enough to know this. No.
It would be.
This would be exactly what I would be doing.
I'm just thinking about, this is a cat torture device.
Yes. It really is. Think of the, remember the weasel balls? The ball that had the little thing that had the tail thing that would roll around?
Right.
Yeah. Anyways. Well, so that's all on YouTube, and I'll link that video in the show notes as well. But yeah, for the person who has everything that you can't think of something to get them, the Sphero app-controlled robotic ball. All
right. And just like that, Navitz has joined the chat room.
So there you go, Steven. Here's your Christmas present this year. You
know, yeah.
Yeah. All right. So that's our list for 2013. Some of the gadgets that we recommend for your Black Friday shopping or any pre-holiday shopping.
Yes.
All right. We started a segment a few weeks ago. We call it Mail Call. So, Matthew.
Mail Call.
Yay. All right.
All right, today's mail call comes from Joel Higginbotham, and this is part of what he sent to us. Hey, this last week's episode was great. I wanted to thank you all for what you do through the show. You all, Heath most of all, got real passionate about youth ministry and how it is affecting the church and how it could be done better to help keep teens in the church as they transition to college. I'm sure you've seen the research or heard of the book, but on the off chance you haven't, you need to look up Kara Powell and the research she is doing through the Fuller Youth Institute. The book and study are called Sticky Faith. So thank you, Joel, for writing. And in the show notes, we've got a link where you can buy Sticky Faith, which is a great book. And also, you can click to view Joel's email in its entirety. And you can tell by his use of the phrase, you all, he is above the Mason-Dixon line.
All right. Also, in our show last week, we were discussing this idea of 20% of youth leave the church. And so in the chat room, my brother Tim Casey was in there and he asked the question, why do 20% stay? And right after that, and we talked about that a little bit, and right after that he found an article and he shot an email saying, in reference to your show today, I coincidentally read this article, Millennial Myths and the Real Reasons People Leave the Church by Rachel Held Evans. He says, if you have time, take a look. And so it's a great article. We link you to that article. Again, the title of it is Millennial Myths and Real Reasons People Leave the Church. And we encourage you to check that out. All right. Tell you what we're going to do here. We're getting short on time, so we'll do our download of the week, and we'll just forego they said it for this week.
Download of the week.
All right, our download of the week, Matthew, this is one that you are bringing to
us. So let me flip back to the show notes here. So this is in the news. You may have heard about Comet Ison. Anybody familiar with Comet Ison?
Yes,
until I told you about
told
it this
me.
Morning?
Okay. Yeah, I just say.
So space stuff, very cool to me. I did a long series in church, and to try to keep it interesting, every Sunday night I would report on what was happening with the with the Mars rover Curiosity.
Which was hilarious.
Yes, so. It was a blast. Well, Ison is a comet that is being pulled towards the sun. It is supposed to graze the sun, and if it stays together, it'll look great in January. And if you're a big-time sky enthusiast, you may have already seen Comet Ison. Well, the app that I have for you today is just a fantastic app, and I don't have it to where I can mirror it, but let me see if I can pull it up here on this device.
This device, go. The brand new iPad
Retina.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you'll be. All right,
it's
there, it's working.
Clear.
Okay. So this throws up into the sky all of the constellations and all of the stars and lets you track, and it's tracked based on your location.
Yeah.
So even right now,
so
it knows where we are.
Location,
now it's not nighttime, so we couldn't go out and see these. But if you were looking this direction from
but
where
if you
we're
had
standing,
night vision,
this is what's coming up. And it even allows you to track Ison. So let me see if I can find. It's a little hard to do this backwards. See if I can. No, I'm not going to be able to find the sun based off where I'm sitting right here. But if you were able to point this up to the sun, you'd be able to see where the comet is. It's getting close to Mercury right now. If you want to see it, you'd need a good telescope or a pair of binoculars, and you've got to be up early in the morning, look off to the east just before the sun rises, and the comet's headed that way. And then if it survives, if it holds together and makes its loop around the sun in January, you'll see it heading off in the other direction up in the sky in the early morning.
So how often does it appear? Is this a one-time
phenomenon? Thing, this is a comet that's never, that there's no record of it appearing before, but it has at some point. If you follow comets to their logical conclusion. So we were talking about Hale-Bopp before the show. Yeah. That comet, fascinating to me as a child, 12 years old when that comet was going on. Fascinating to me.
Also freaked him out.
It did. Yeah. The whole thing about aliens scared me to death. I remember standing out there. Yes, I remember standing out there in the street in Miles City, Montana on a cold night, you know, watching this comet and seeing it. It was absolutely fascinating. That comet in its orbit passes by every 4,100 years, which meant, and you may remember this, meant that Abraham would have been alive the last time that comet passed through our viewing ability. This comet probably has at some point too. I don't know all the history on it, but it's on every time. It's like they get closer and closer to the sun. So in another 4,000 years, when Hale-Bopp comes back around, it'll be a little closer to the sun, and they risk destruction. The closer you are, the easier it is for it to burn up. And this thing's literally passing between where Mercury is and where the sun is, and Mercury being the closest planet to the sun. And the sun, it's, you know, there's nobody knows for sure. It might survive. It might break apart when it gets that close.
Let me say, I mean, this is just a cool app.
Yeah.
Especially for, so how does it work? Yeah. How does it know where you're oriented? Okay,
so the first thing it does is it uses the GPS in the device to put you in the correct place on the Earth. Then it uses the accelerometer and the gyroscope inside of it to go out. So like last night, I was outside with Ashley and we were looking around. And when you point it, like, it lines up the stars on the screen with what's in the sky. It's pointing the same way. And so, like, it's super easy to find the North Star, to find different constellations and do all that. Like, Orion is exactly where it was supposed to be because it knew where I was physically located. And then it depends. Like, the stars aren't the same in Miles City as they are here. It all depends on where you are on the planet. So it uses a combination of GPS and of gyroscopes. Super cool. $2 to buy it. Wow. But super educational. Every one of the stars that you see on this device, you can click on it.
Our real
you can
stars.
Learn about it. Yes. You can learn about it. You can figure out when it was discovered. Oh, satellites. Wow. There's an internet purchase to where you can see satellites orbiting the Hubble Space Telescope, the International Space Station. Get all that information. Really cool app for $1.99.
That's not the Christmas star. That's the light at the sewage treatment plant, Grizz.
All right. Well, listen, big thanks to you, Heath, for being such a great sport.
Man, you guys know that I'll do anything for the show. This is really hot.
I bet it is.
I'm about to, you know.
We knew you'd warm up. All right, let me talk about what's coming up here on the future. Next week, we're going to have Marie Cattle with us. She is a nurse who works at the Wesleyan Hospital on the island of La Guinave in Haiti. And we have come to admire her and her work, and also the work of her husband, who was actually the engineer in charge of the building of the new hospital there. And we want to get him on at a separate time to talk about that. On December the 3rd, my brother, Tim Casey, is going to be with us. And we're going to talk about Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol and some of the Christian themes, even though Dickens isn't Christian, or we just don't know. But yet he has a lot of Christian themes in that. And my brother and I kind of stumbled along for the last 5 years now. Every year I've read this just leading up to Christmas, only to find out that my brother's been doing this for 20 years. And there are large chunks of the opening paragraphs that he can just quote from memory. Matthew, on December the 10th, this is going to be an interesting one.
Yeah, we're excited. I was actually just talking with these guys this morning. There's a company called Skydog. They are making a router for the home that is intended to make the administration of a network in a family setting simple.
Yeah.
So what that means is internet filtering, time allowance for devices to use the internet, reporting, opening up those kinds of conversations that may need to happen inside a family. Very cool what they're doing. Like, this isn't like Focus on the Family or something like that. This is just a company that was doing business class routing who thought, you know, we just need to do this. We want to talk to them about why they're doing this for the family, why they feel like it's important. Hugely proud of what is happening with this company and excited about what they're providing. And I can think of family after family inside my own church that needs something like this, that needs a simple way, because, I mean, not everybody's me. Not everybody hey, knows man. What it means to go build an untangle router and set that up inside your own home. It's complicated. There's a lot to that. So a simple way of doing that and administrating that and knowing that you're taking steps to keep your family safe, to encourage the appropriate kinds of conversations about the internet and what it means to use it. Absolutely fantastic, and we're excited to talk to them on December the 10th.
And also in December, we're going to have Michael Cusack on the 17th. His book, Surfing for God, he takes that title and really borrows it from something that G.K. Chesterton said over a century ago. And this is kind of a paraphrase, but he said, every man who's knocking at the door of a brothel is in search of God. And so you can see how he takes that and this whole thing of people who surf the internet for porn. He talks about the pain of his own story being hooked on internet pornography, but way beyond that, and how he came out of that. He now is a counselor and helps other people. So really looking forward to that. And then we've got other guests. Just encourage you to take a look at our show notes. You'll see our schedule. They're excited about 2014, and our calendar is really shaping up for just another great year.
And I wrote all of them on my Seize the Year 2014 calendar.
That's great. All right. So, Heath, where can people find you or copies of A Christmas Story?
They can go to heathmulliken.com. I'll be posting an update there later today about my wife and I. So, hope to see you there and on the internet.
You can find me at matthewtg.com or at home brewing a latte for my wife.
And I'm at AKC64 at Facebook and Twitter. If you want to contact us, we just encourage you to send your emails to thetechologyshow@gmail.com. Or better yet, we'd love to have a voicemail from you. Call us at 3049-TEOLOGY. Leave us a message, and we may even play your comments on the air. Again, thank you to Heath for being a great sport. Thank you for being with us today. Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Merry Christmas. Hold on, I gotta get the gloves on.